YOLOv11 is officially out, and in this video, I'll be teaching you how to run inference on both video files and images using this particular model. I've prepared a Google Colab notebook for you, and the link of this notebook will be in the video description, so all you need to do is to send in the video file and the images you want to run inference on. YOLOv11 is an amazing model and you will not like to miss this particular tutorial. Ready to do it? Let's get right into it. Alright, so I've prepared a Colab notebook for this particular tutorial and the link to this notebook will be in the video description. All you need to do is to click on this link and it will open this particular notebook for you. So when you open this notebook, the first thing you have to do is to get your images and videos you'll be using for this particular tutorial. So in my case, I have some images and videos on my desktop, so I'll just drag and drop them here. So I'll drop the image, and depending on the size of your image file and the video file, it might take long to load. Right after that, I'll go ahead and change my runtime to GPU. I want to utilize the GPU so that I can run these models very fast. So make sure you check this radio button T4 GPU and click on save. Okay, so our video file is loaded, our image is also loaded. From here, the next thing is to install Ultralytics. So you just run this cell and this cell will go ahead and install Ultralytics. Okay, so we are installing it in the quiet mode, so you don't see a lot of drop downs from here. Right from installing Ultralytics, now we import the libraries we need. So we need two libraries. We need IPython to display both our video results and our image results, and also need YOLO from Ultralytics. So run this cell and this will import these libraries after our installation has been done successfully. Okay, so we got a success check mark, and from here now we have to detect on images. So to detect on images, we have to first instantiate our YOLO instance. So you can see our model here is YOLO. And right here, we are specifying that we are using YOLO 11N, which is the nano model. Okay, so when you go to the Ultralytics website, YOLO 11 comes in 5 different models. You will get the nano version, the smaller version, the medium, the large, and the X version. So all of these versions are very good. And depending on your tasks, you might choose one version or the other. The nano version is very fast, so computationally, it's not that expensive. The smaller version is bigger than the nano version. So the bigger the model, the better it is, but at the same time, it has higher computational requirements. In our case, we'll be using the nano version. If you want to use the smaller version, all you need to do is to change N here to S. The same thing, if you want to use the medium version, change it to M and so on. But in our case, we'll change it back to N, and that's the model we are going to use. Then from here, we have to give the path to the image you want to run inference on. So I've uploaded the image here. So I'll just copy the path of this image right here. And I'll close this back. And I'm going to update this path with the path I've copied. Then that's all. So this will run the inference on the image and save it in our working directory. Then from that, I'm just looping through the results to print the number of objects detected in the image. So that's all, and I'll run this cell, and this is going to download the model. So you can see the YOLO 11N model have been downloaded successfully, and then we are done with running the inference. So from here, you can see we've gotten 5 persons, 1 couch, 1 potted plant, 1 book from the results. And from here, we can now go ahead and visualize these results. So right after the detection, you can see everything is saved in a folder called runs, detect, and predict. And this folder is in your same working directory. So you can see runs, detect, and predict. And inside predict, you can see the result. So you just have to copy the same path here and make sure you put it in this particular place so that you can display your result. So I'll put it here and I'll run this cell. And this is going to show my results. So you can see this is the image we brought in, and this is how good YOLOv11 is detecting people in this particular image. I think the results are quite well, and I can see some overlapping bounding boxes. Oh, okay, that's for the couch, but I think this result is pretty decent. What do you guys think? Leave your opinion in the comment section for us.
Okay, from here, if you want to see all the results, you can also access result at zero. Okay, so I'll hide this. So the final step here is to run inference on video files. And for that, I've instantiated the model again, even though we have done it at the top, but I've reinstantiated the model again. And over here, you just have to put in the path for your video file. So we have the video here, and I'll just come and copy the path to the video file, which is right here. And over here, I'll just put in this same path. And I'll run this cell. So this will go ahead and extract all the frames. Okay, so we got an error saying, okay, I think we have a problem with the path. They should solve it. So this will extract the video frame by frame, and it will try to detect all the objects. So whatever is detecting, you can see it's being written down here, sports ball and so on. All right, so it's done running on the video file, and the result once again is saved in runs detect predict 2. Okay, so we can go back and get the path to display this result. So over here, I'll go to runs. We have detect and predict 2. And inside predict 2, you can see we have the video file here. So you can download it, and you can also try to visualize this with the IPython library. So to do that, it's not able to download, but I've already downloaded this video. So I'll paste in the path here and see if we can display this video with IPython. I've already done this, so I've saved the result video on my desktop, which I'll be playing for you guys to see. So since this is taking long, I'll just come back to my desktop, and this is the result. So this is how well Yolovi 11 is performing on the video file. I think it's performing quite well. It's detecting the sport ball with a very high accuracy, and also the players as well. So guys, this is meant to be a very short tutorial on how you can just run inference using Yolovi 11. So let me have your thoughts in the comment section, and also I'll be making a video on how to train your custom object detector using Yolovi 11. I'll also be running Yolovi 11 on a live webcam to see how it will also perform in the real world scenario. So thanks for watching this tutorial, and I'll see you in my next tutorial.